So it's finally that time of the month where we're going used PC parts hunting, and last month we managed to get a HD 6950 and also an all-in-one PC for pretty good prices. This month, yet again, we're going to be looking for some used GPUs and seeing if we can snap up some bargains. Welcome back to Tech Yes City, and let's pull up those deals. So the first deal we've pulled up here, I'm really excited about. It's a GTX 690. Now, I've never tried one of these cards personally. I've always wanted to get one, and now it looks like the price is right. Reed is selling one of these for $165 Australian, and that is in US dollars about $132. So it's a really good price even for what he's asking at the moment, because one Australian dollar is weaker than a US dollar. It's like 80 US cents. So we're gonna give him a call, of course, and try and even put in a little bit lower of an offer, maybe pick it up for 150 Australian dollars even. So let's put on that Bogan voice and see if we can get the deal.
Hello, Reed speaking.
Hey Reed, how you going, mate?
Yeah, good.
Yeah, I saw your ad on Gumtree for GTX 690.
Yep.
Yeah, mate, would you take 150 for one of them?
I would prefer to keep them together for now, man.
I see selling both of them for 300.
Yeah.
So two 690s for 300.
That's correct, man.
You won't go any lower?
No, unfortunately not, man. They're already cheap as they are.
Oh, I know, mate. Just always trying to get a deal, you know?
Yeah, nah, fair enough, man. Do you mind if I call you back after work? I'm just at work right now.
Yeah, no worries. Just I'll come pick him up for 300. You just text us your address, mate, and tell me what time to pick him up.
Yeah, sweet as, man.
All right. Thanks, mate.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye.
So we just got off the phone to Reed, and he only wanted to sell both the cards for 300 Australian dollars, which is like 240 USD. And honestly, I'm not going to argue with that price. I'm just going to take it, because if I don't, someone else will definitely pick that up, because that is a really good deal at its current price. So we're going to move on to the next deal, which is a GTX 970. Now the seller wants 280 Australian dollars for it, but we're going to drop in an offer of $200, since of course the GTX 1060 is already out, and that's already good performance for the dollar.
Hello.
Hey Reese, how you going, mate?
Good, mate.
Yeah, I saw you out on Gumtree for a GTX 970.
Correct.
Yeah, would you take 200 for it?
Nah, I've had offer 250 so far.
Ah, it's just that there's the GTX 1060s that are out, and they go for around 300. So
6 gigabyte one?
The 3 gigabyte ones.
Yeah. I don't know how much difference they are between the 970 and the 1060 3 gigabyte, but the 970's got 4 gigabyte, so I don't, yeah.
I thought they had 3.5.
What, the 970s?
Yeah.
Oh, it says on the box 4 gig, so.
Oh, okay, mate, no worries. Yeah, all right, yeah, 250's pretty good, mate. All right, thanks for that.
Thanks, mate.
Bye.
See you, buddy.
So we just got off the phone to Reese, and he wanted 250 Australian for his 970, and that's not really a good deal at that price. And what I said on the phone was pretty much the truth. A 1060 at 300 with 3 gigabytes uses less power. It's also got warranty, and I believe it'll actually perform better on average than a 970 will anyway. So yeah, that's kind of a miss on that deal. So before we move on to the next deal, I wanted to talk about today's video sponsor, Audible. With Audible, you can download any of your favorite books and then just simply listen to them across many different platforms like iOS, Windows, and Android. And all you have to do is sign up, and you get a 30-day free trial with a credit, which will be able to purchase a book completely free. I decided to use the credit on my favorite book of all time, How to Win Friends and Influence People. It's an incredible book. It should actually be called How to Communicate with People and Better Yourself as a Person, because that's what this book does. It's incredible for making new friends, talking to people, and just in general, making yourself a better person. I've read this book, and now I'm listening to it on Audible. So in the modern day age, if you don't have time to read, or you just simply don't like reading, then Audible is a really good solution. There's also tons of different categories like like sci-fi, mystery, romance that you can browse through, download these books, and just simply listen to them rather than reading. They've also got the option to share books between friends and also many other different configurations that you can use on this website. So if you want to trial it for free, then head on into the link. I'll put it in the description below, audible.com/techyescity. For a free 30-day trial, you can cancel at any time in those 30 days if you don't like the service. So there's nothing to lose and a lot to gain. Anyway, guys, link is in the description below. Let's get back to those deals. So the next deal we've got up here is another GTX 970. This is a Strix edition. He's asking $250 for it, but unfortunately there is no number to call. So we're just gonna drop in an offer of 200, see if they'll take it. So the next deal I'm pulling up here is an R9 280, and I believe they're similar in performance to a HD 7950. This is a 3GB model, very good card for gaming. He's asking 140 Australian dollars for it. I put in an offer of 100 Australian dollars, which would be about 80 USD, and he doesn't have a number to call again. So now the last deal we got up here for graphics cards is two GTX 780 Windforce editions. Now the seller is asking 200 Australian dollars each for one of these cards. I'm gonna put in an offer of 300 Australian dollars for the pair, which is about 240 USD, see if he takes that. And again, there's no number to call here, so I'm guessing there's maybe a bit of a trend going on with Gumtree, and that is people don't want bogans like myself calling up. So besides the graphics cards, there's now two other deals that I'm pulling up here. The first is DDR3 memory. Always need DDR3 memory for a good build. And the seller is asking $80 for 16 gigabytes of DDR3 memory. We're gonna drop in and give him a call and drop in an offer of 60 Australian dollars, which is like 48 US dollars, for 4 sticks of DDR3 memory and see how it goes.
Hello.
Hello, Kai, how are you?
Pretty good, how are you?
Good, mate. I saw your advertisement on Gumtree for DDR3 4GB memory.
Yeah, that's right. Unfortunately, I only have one left. Some guy bought three.
Oh. Would you take $15 for one stick?
Yeah, all right. Yeah, $15, yeah.
Okay, mate, just text me your address and I'll come pick her up.
Yeah, okay. Can you come a little bit late this afternoon? Maybe 3 o'clock, because I'm outside at the moment. Is that okay for you?
Yeah, that's fine, mate. Just text me the time and the address.
Yeah, sure. No problem.
Thanks, Kai.
No worries. See you then.
Bye. So Kai said that he already sold 3 sticks of memory, so again, I put in an offer with the price scaling to my original offer, and he accepted that, so we're gonna go collect that a little bit later. So now the last deal we got up here is a desktop PC with LGA 1156 and 8GB of memory, so it doesn't look too bad. It's an OEM PC, they're asking 175 Australian dollars for it. We're gonna try and drop in an offer of 100 Australian dollars, which will be about 80 USD, and if we can get it for that price, it'll be a pretty good pickup.
Hello.
Hello, Karen, how are you?
Good, thanks.
Yeah, I saw your advertisement on gumtree.com.au for a desktop computer.
Oh, yeah, yep.
Yeah, I just need the box, like the actual computer. So would you like take 100 for it?
Yeah, I suppose so, yep.
Yeah, 100 bucks. When could I pick her up?
I'm home all day today if you wanted to come by.
No worries. Well, I'm just making a few rounds, so if you could just text us your address and I'll come through and pick her up.
All right, no worries.
All right, thanks, Karen.
That's okay.
Bye. So we just got off the phone and we got that for 100 Australian dollars, which is like 80 USD. So now we've got 3 deals confirmed. I'm just waiting for all the texts to come through with the times. That's actually coming through now. So just waiting for a few more texts and addresses and times to come through. Then I'm gonna go pick up all these parts a bit later on. We're also waiting on those offers to come back for 2 of those graphics cards that I sent via Gumtree. So hopefully they come back before the afternoon when we go to pick up some of these parts. And of course, I wanna go and test out all these parts to make sure that we don't get hosed.
Also, a big thank you for some of you guys who have sent in some parts completely free over the last few months, some of them which you'd like me to test, so I'm going to be making a dedicated video to that. One of the most curious parts is a Ryzen CPU with bent pins on it, which is crazy, like a lot of these pins are bent, so I'm going to be having a fun time seeing if I can fix this up and seeing if it works still. So now it's time to go pick up some of these deals, and the guy with the GTX 780s actually got back to me and said he accepted my offer. So we're gonna go pick up that as well. Unfortunately, the GTX 690s, he hasn't messaged me back yet, but he did say he was at work. So hopefully when he's on the road, he'll message us and we can go pick them up as well. But let's get out of here because I've... So I just got back now from picking up three of the four deals. The 690 guy, I'm still waiting on a reply from him. So hopefully he replies before dinner. If it goes on after dinner, then I'm guessing he's just not keen and he's maybe found another deal or something like that. But we got here two 780s, picked these up for 300 Australian or 240 USD. Gonna clean them up and see if they work. This here is the desktop PC that we got for 100 AUD or 80 USD. Now the lady was kind enough to show us this thing fully working. So we know it's awesome. We know it works. And she even threw in the Windows 7 Ultimate. So we should be able to upgrade this to Windows 10. It should be all good. Then we've got a free keyboard and mouse she threw in. She actually threw in a monitor as well. Now usually I wouldn't take the monitor, but I will be building a NAS soon. And something like this is perfect for a NAS. You don't need any fancy monitors just for a NAS system, so that'll be really good. And then the DDR3 memory, we can actually just drop this in this rig and see if it works. So that's an easy fix, but let's get on to cleaning up these parts and making them look a little bit better than they are now. So we're cleaning up this PC now, and it is by far one of the dirtiest PCs I've seen in my life. The fans were just filthy, it was covered in dust, and the good news is we've cleaned it all up now. And it's got a P55 ASUS motherboard in there, 4-core 750 i5, 8GB of memory, and a 500W Cooler Master power supply. So this is really good value for money. Not only that, it's got a 1TB hard drive. It also has a 9600 GT, which is a completely useless graphics card. So we're gonna put in something like a 750 Ti, because ironically enough, this power supply doesn't have any PCI Express cables, even though it's got a good dual 20 amp 12 volt rail, which is really odd. But let's put this thing back together and make it shine. So now we're just going to test the first graphics card and see if this boots up. And even after that, I actually want to stress it in Unigine Heaven to to see if we need to change the thermal paste as well. But because it's a 780, it should be okay. I think it should be fine. So the first GTX 780 we have up here is running absolutely fine. It's working perfectly. It's hovering around 70 degrees and the fans are really quiet. I think that's normal, but it might benefit from a thermal paste change. And this GTX 780 is running perfectly fine as well. One interesting thing to note is that this one is not the GHZ edition and doesn't have the backplate either. So it is a little bit slower, but it does have the same cooling solution. So with that, it should be, as you can see here, running a little bit cooler than the GHZ edition, which it is. And now for this last part, we've got this PC that we cleaned up and we've also put the 750 Ti in and that 4GB stick that we bought earlier. So hopefully we can kill two birds with one stone. We have a signal, we are working, and it looks like everything is good to go. The fans are a little bit noisy, however. One of these fans will definitely need to be replaced. Well, I think we found the culprit. So all the parts we picked up here today are working perfectly fine, and also some really awesome news is that the guy with the GTX 690s has gotten back to me, albeit it's pretty late at night. So we're gonna go pick these up now and see how good they are. So I just got back from meeting up with Reed and he had the two GTX 690s for $300. We'll test them out soon just to make sure that they work, although he said that they did work and they were perfectly fine. He actually showed me a screenshot of them working. But also I talked to him on the phone and he was also keen for an RGB keyboard, and I told him I had a Cool Master Master Keys Pro L lying around and he started to offer me parts like an X58 motherboard, 10 gigabytes of DDR3 memory, i7-980X, a Corsair case. And at this stage I was like, yeah, definitely, I'll take this keyboard off my hands, I want these parts. And he even threw in some EK water block fittings as well. So that was really cool. So I was really happy with that other deal that I got on top of the GTX 690s. But let's go quickly test these out, make sure they work. And it's actually really late at night, but we'll just quickly try and boot up this X58 board as well. So there it is, guys, all the parts we've got through here today are working and they're working perfectly fine. I am just amazed. Everything we've got through here is not missing a beat, except for one of the GTX 690s. You may have seen in the footage that one of the cores was going over 90 degrees, so I'll have to pull this apart and replace the thermal paste and then recheck the temperatures. And I think that goes for every used Gravis card I'm gonna pick up from now. I think I'll just replace the thermal paste anyway. It's not only gonna get you better temperatures, in some cases a lot better temperatures, but it's just great for peace of mind going forward. I find usually in half the cases of used GPUs, I have to replace the thermal paste to get the GPU working fine. So I should just make it a practice to do it on every used GPU that I buy from here on in. But when it all comes down to it, we got four graphics cards today, two GTX 780s, two GTX 690s, which I've never even laid hands on in my life before, and we got them for a really good price, really good deal. Got a whole PC with a P55 motherboard, good power supply, 8 GB of memory, i5-754 core, overclockable, decent case, all this in a stick of DDR3 memory, some water block fittings, an i7-980X, an X58 motherboard, and 10 gigabytes of DDR3 memory on that, all for $715. Man, this is easily like the best day of used parts PC hunting in my life. This is crazy good. I'm stoked. I hope you guys have enjoyed today's video. And with that said, a big thank you to today's sponsor, Audible. And if you guys want to know how I do the deals, how I interact with people, because there's actually a lot more to the story with the last deal that I got, which I'll probably talk about sometime in the future. But if you guys want to know how to get the deals like I do, you want to better yourself as a person, then head over to audible.com, links in the description below, get yourself a free trial and get that book, How to Win Friends and Influence People. Really good listen. I'm actually listening to it now. I've read it, I'm gonna listen to it, and enjoy it again. And that's it for me today, guys. If you enjoyed today's video, then don't forget to hit that like button and let me know in the comment section below, what was your favorite deal of today? I actually have to take a step back. I'm gonna go have a sleep, take a step back in the morning and take a look at all these deals and decide which one was my favorite, because they were all friggin' pretty good today. I was just amazed. We got some really good deals. So stoked. And I'll catch you guys in another tech video very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.
Oh, it's so worth it.
So check that out. The GTX 690 actually doesn't have a HDMI port, so I had to use a display port to HDMI, or actually a mini display port to display port to HDMI ports. So that's two adapters just to get a signal to my capture card. That's crazy. And also a big thank you to you guys on Twitter. I asked you guys what parts I should go searching for. Some mentioned like GTX 1060s, 1050 Ti's, and some other things like an R9 Fury. I couldn't find any of those parts. I did search for them, so thanks for your suggestions. However, one of the suggestions, a GTX 690, was a gold suggestion, so thanks for that. Also, Kev from Tech Showdown mentioned that I should look for a FX 9590. We're coming out of winter here in Australia, so I'm not ready. Jokes aside, I'm not ready to put a heater in my house.